昨晩ザ・シャックスが私のお家のリビングルームで演奏をしていた夢を見たの。一緒に歌って一緒に踊って頭が素晴らしいメロディーで溢れていたわ。本当に素敵な夢だったの。
Thank you. Hello? Hello? If I came here, I'd be so obnoxious on purpose. I'd be like, eh? Yakuza de shou? Eh? Chinatown desu? Yokohama daisuki? I'd take up the whole fucking road. I'd be spinning my arms like, Snow White. Wait for the birds to come drop. I'd be like, eh? Ichiban daisuki? And then, I'd start jerking off like one of those Indians. I I don't want to say I need you guys to help me, because it would be very strange. It's probably illegal, too, so I'm not going to ask for that type of video. But I will let you know, I'm trying to amass a great collection of Indians jerking off at people and staring at them with blank, lifeless, soulless stares, because I've got two, and I know there's a third one out there that I haven't saved, and that makes me think there's got to be more. Because it's just, I don't know. That is a subsection of genre of video that is near and dear to my heart. Those cute little taxis from the 90s or 80s. Oh yeah, there's that one too with the guy in the UK where he's jerking off and the guy kicks him in the back. I guess that counts too. So there's four. Which means there has to be way more. Gotta find them.
Gotta find them. So happy.
Honk shoe, honk shoe.
Me before I wake up as a better person tomorrow. 2024 is my year. It's my time. Yeah, it's my time. What's wrong with him? Lost 30 pounds this year? That's great, dude. I gained 15. But I lost 85 the year before, so, I mean, whatever. Net value, I'm like 70. It's fine. I can get rid of it. It's easy. Just not tonight. I'll do it tomorrow. Went from streaming almost every day to streaming once a week. What happened to us, Chad? No! This thread got deleted. Oh. No! Please! I asked for source, and I was never given the sauce. They said, give me the sauce, and never gave it to me. Many such cases. So sad. We are so not back. That's it. Fuck it. We're not gooning this New Year's. It's over. Masturbation is illegal now. New Year's bad. I saved the VTuber video. What was this? I must have been drunk 3 weeks ago. Guys, is this? Check this out. Is this cringe or is it Kino? Let's look together. What is this? Do you think? That was cringe Kina. You fucking VTuber friends. You give them an inch, they take a mile. They see one VTuber, they start mentioning all the other ones. They're like, what about this one? This is your VTubers. This is me eating them on New Year's after I break into their house. I like the image. Got a tickle in my throat. I went for a run in the wind. And I can't breathe. I can't fucking breathe. I like that one image of some guy just staring at the screen and it's a little anime girl not moving. And the chat's like, chat's going crazy and there's just like sounds of rape and chaos and destruction in the background. But her little avatar's smiling, staring at the screen, and so he's like, I'm sure she's fine. That was cool. Back out!
Where is that song? Yippee, but it's Jazz TBH Creature. 2.3 million views. Hmm? Eh? This place, I've been here. This is where they have Dragon Card. It sucks that Yakuza 8's probably not going to bring Dragon Card back, because with some fine tuning, it could have actually been fun. And it was kind of fun once I got past the jank, but grinding Dragon Card really wasn't that great. You know, I've done everything that there is to do in Yakuza 7. Except finish that final fucking dungeon. The DLC one. Because it's nothing but power creep. You just have to grind another dungeon until you can do the final dungeon. And I did grind. Like, non-stop. And then I went, I don't want to do this anymore. And I stopped. And I did that of my own volition. So, moral of the story is, this New Year's, you can stop. You can put an end to any vice that you have as soon as the clock strikes 12. You can do it. Some of you. Maybe not you. Yeah, you can't, probably. You can. Not that one. That one can't. Maybe not you. I don't know. I'm gonna play, I'm not just making butt jokes because I can't think of a title. I'm not making butt jokes for my fucking stream title because I'm creatively bankrupt, okay? We're gonna play a butt game. Saw it on YouTube. I'm gonna play it before all the other big streamers do. Cause I'm shit. It's gonna explode. It's gonna be one of those games that everyone's gonna play for a laugh. And someone told me it's very scary. I don't know about that. No, not Nikkei. Speaking of Nikkei, that new girl came out who's like OP, Scarlet Black or whatever. I don't even know her name. I got her though. Of course. Yeah, I've been enjoying Flip Witch, Sex Hacks. That one's a good one. That's a fun Metroidvania. And if you lose, ghost girls and orc girls have sex with you. Or if you're a boy, because you can flip your sex on the fly, then, the girls have sex with you if you're a boy. And the boys have sex with you if you're a girl. Look at those cool chairs. Do you think they warm you as well, or they just light up? This place looks fun. I should go outside. Oh, there's actually a place that's probably lit up tonight. I'm not going to do that, though. I have too much to do tonight. I'm going to stream with you guys for a few hours. And then I'm having a little Discord watch party with the bros. We're going to watch Goodfellas tonight. And then, when that's over, it'll probably be midnight or past midnight. And then I'm just going to play Grand Blue all by myself. Because for some reason, I can't stop playing that game. Not the fucking gacha, the fighting game. See my whack-ass Saurus. See my whack-ass Saurus. See my pocket Anila. Yeah, I like it. It's very simple. It's simple and the lobbies are intuitive. So, It's already 50% better than every other online fighting game. Alright, let's play this butt game. Do I need a controller for this? I don't know. We just don't know. I think I'm going to keep the little cat picture up. If you guys want me to get rid of it, tell me. I'll ignore you. Misato has to go. Misato said she wouldn't kiss me on New Year's. Oh, wait a minute. That reminds me. That last Christmas stuck in my head for like 3 weeks now.
What are we gonna do?
Yeah, that's a keeper. That's a good one right there. New Year's kiss. You guys are kissing someone on New Year's, right? Oh, tell me, baby, who do you rely on? In other words, who's your beep beep doo boo boo? Damn, damn. I have to go to the DMV, boys. Should I stream it? My life is an advertisement. You know, when I'm out sometimes, out walking amongst nature, I was having my nice walk in the cool, crisp air in the sun today. All I could think was, now this could be content. I held my phone in front of people, and I took a selfie, and I started making wacky faces at my phone while interrupting their day. I said, and then I said, you just got Fandangoed. Whatever my catchphrase is. And then the TikTok logo goes, da-boom. This fucking old 86-year-old woman who's just jump-scared by someone who has no idea what's going on. Maybe this is scary. Do I play this in... Oh, that made it stop. Alright, I should probably change the... Huh? How do you play this game? What the... Is there no mouse for this game? I told you I was playing a butt game. You thought I was lying. This is like a literal poop killer, I think. October's a lot colder than you remember. Yeah. That's what I've been saying. That's what I've been saying. Yeah, I know the game is loud. Grandpa's gotta move at the speed of a snail to adjust everything else. I have my gamer frickin' setup. Okay, you're really gonna ruin this TikTok. That's it, I'm hitting you with a cringe TikTok because you won't shut your frickin' mouth.
Ah, she was a fucking handful to get in there. It's alright, buddy. We're about to do some donuts.
We in New Zealand.
I don't think, mouse?
letting me use the weapons. He likes it.
How was that cringe? I don't know. Wow, you guys cracked the code. I put a million shitty videos in a row on my OBS, and I don't know which is which, and I just click one and hope, like, I don't know, maybe this will have some implication as to what I just said. Some relevance. Well, there's a sheep doing donuts, and you know what? If that doesn't have to do with colonoscopies, I don't know what does. Alright, there's no mouse right now, so let's go. I'm a gastroenterologist. Oh, there's the mouse. Specialized doctor with expertise in diagnosing and treating diseases of the digestive tract. Yeah, or an ass man. One of the most common procedures you can perform is the colonoscopy. The insertion of a camera deep into the large intestine via the anus. You've been performing colonoscopies for decades and have treated thousands of patients. You are well respected among your peers and a regular speaker at all the important annual conferences, like ButtCon 2023. You've seen it all and treated it all. Nothing phases you. There is nothing you cannot handle. You're the Michael Jordan of gastroenterology. Okay. You do not know it yet, but this is your final week. I am so immature. I'm looking at black screens with white words, and I'm already have a huge smile on my face because I know that I'm gonna be in someone's butt, which isn't a laughing matter. Well, there's your problem. You got a leaky faucet. Case closed. Paperclip. Take care of it. Should also check out Buckshot Roulette. I haven't opened another tab. I was going to play it if this was too short, because that shit looks awesome. Buckshot Roulette speaks to me. That's also one you're probably going to see a lot of streamers playing lately. I think these are both going to blow up. They're going to be big meme games. It's been nearly 70 years since I've been on holiday abroad. Watching the news about border control guards and their brutish behavior. After we arrived in Calais. We're waiting in line. I saw a horrid expression on the guard's face. It gave me such a fright, I took off my wedding ring and swallowed it. What? I thought he might take it from me. Eventually, we passed through the border without any trouble, although he was quite rude. He didn't speak any English at all. It's been over a week. I've returned and my ring has not reappeared. I can see how this might be spooky, I guess. It's quite likely that the ring did leave your body and you simply did not see it. I am an expert in poop. For no particular reason. Last name, Bajit. Quite sure it has not come out. I can feel it. My husband Harold has much better eyesight than I have. He has done all the searching. Certainly have a dedicated husband, Mrs. Hargreaves. I think we should get started. See your asshole. I'm just looking for my business cards up in this anus. Is there actual poop in this game? I don't want to see that. Oh. I had to check. I can't take a peek. Damn, Granny, she puckered. Damn, Graham. work out. Sheesh. No one's been in here before, I see. Oh. Scan and analyze your patient's colon. The grabber. Pulling objects free that are stuck or pierced into the colon. I'm not gonna remember this stuff. The cutter. The cauterizer. No patient should be left with a bleeding colon. That's the opposite of what I tell them. I tell them it's natural. I tell them to put on a blindfold and assume the position. They're like, oh my god, is it always this rough? I'm like, yeah! Oh, I probably shouldn't do that. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Oh, man. I feel bad about that. Well, there's no poop yet, so that's good, I guess. I don't know what it is. I, like, don't really want to see poop. This is as fast as I can go, I believe. Oh, do I have anything else? The flusher. Flush objects, dead flesh, or anything else out of the colon with a warm jet of water. Looks gross. I mean, you're gonna say they make you cleanse before, but how good can Granny clean, you know? She's got weak bones. Her tendons are suffering. She's got arthritis. She can't spread eagle like she used to. In front of the mirror. For OnlyFans. This is 2050. All the OnlyFans girls are getting colonoscopies. Because they all have ruptures in their anus. It's finally catching up to them. All the Twitch streamers and kids who are born on the internet are in the same asylums. That looks suspicious. A colon polyp. Dude, fuck this thing. Gross! Can you feel that? Oh no. Alright, let's get in there. Flush away the polyp remnants. Then, is that it? Does that feel good? This is really just power wash simulator when you think about it. Okay. Trust me, it's pivotal to the process. I don't see how this is gonna get scary. I'm gonna say it. I don't think this is gonna get a whoa out of me. It's gonna, if it is, it'll be something cheap. I'll put like a 10-minute on. feel like that probably feels really good after the cauterization. Oh, whoops, where's my chat? See, I read you guys. I'm better at this game than real doctors. Oh, I didn't flush away the polyp remains over here.
Little creme de la creme.
Is that a fucking baby? That would be scary. I don't want to see a baby. What is that? Pee is stored in the colon. Yeah. Is that what your dad told you? Your dad said no, trust me, son, it's normal. I'm sorry, your father's probably a great person. I'm him.
Can you feel that?
I'm deep inside Graham Guttage. Finally. What a fucking asshole cutscene. Is that what I'm getting? No jump scares. I'm not gonna whoa. Oh no, it's loading the next area. The paste and cringe, the cringy basado streams killed the economy. Not my problem, you guys don't know what's based and what's cringe.
Literally not my fucking problem.
I didn't call psychopaths cringe, I said psychopaths was epic. Can I kill her? Oh my god! I don't want to redo this, so I should probably stop. I'm initiating malpractice. Your polyps, madame. I'm sure she wants these in a doggy bag or something. Well, there's a baby. Oh, man. Why am I... What? Not every ailment can be treated the same way? Oh, this is fat and calcium. Could become bigger over time, causing blockage. Should be removed. I'm glad. The game will end differently if any ailments are left? Well, we're gonna get the perfect ending. I already know they want me to use a cauterizer for this bitch. That's disgusting. This would be a funny game. That is just grossing me out. Good thing anime girls don't have this crap in them. Favorite treat among old ladies across Great Britain. I know how to do this one. Grip it and rip it. Oops. Do you want that cauterized? Or? probably didn't need to do that. So is this, am I just down there on the other end? I'm like using this tool and then I'm just down there picking out the little pieces with my fingers out of this 86-year-old woman. I gotta tickle it to make it open. Say tickle, tickle. Getting dangerously close to poop. When I see poop, I quit. Can I just flush these? Turn into popcorn. Wasted opportunity, Dev. Wasted opportunity. I don't even have to, like, aim backwards. I just shoot them and they just go down the poop chute. Yeah, alright. Bye-bye. It really is that easy, isn't it? You just shoot them once and they just go away. It's like a sentient psilocybin taking them away. What is this bad boy? Let's have a peep. Or is it just another polyp? I can see this game scaring me if something like jumps out, which it looks like is probably gonna happen. I don't think I have to worry about having butt troubles in my life. Maybe due to unforeseen consequences when I'm older, but nothing goes in there and I eat more fiber than anyone. Should be fine. Also, I can't get cancer. Whoops. Pretty long, huh? Tickle, tickle. This game is luring me into a false sense of security. I do declare. Are disgusting. Probably get a bad ending if you don't clear every bit of the debris, which I can see happening. Not gonna make me do it again, right? Game's kind of relaxing. I feel like if you had like someone who's really high, a friend who is really high, you could show them this game and be like, dude, I know it sounds silly. You go into a colon and it's like, it's gross. You have to like break polyps and shit, but it's actually really relaxing. And they would just veg out and play it. And then a jump scare happens and they'd probably have a heart attack and it would be your fault. This isn't a guy, we're in a grandma. We're in a grandma. The lore is that the grandma... This is the prequel to Poop Killer, by the way. What is that? I don't have to follow these things, do I? The grandma was at the TSA and thought that the big bad Mexican was gonna take her wedding ring. So she swallowed it out of pure fright. This is fucking disgusting. What the hell is that? Alright, she's bleeding. Thought I was gonna not be able to play this with a mouse. That would have been terrible. Oh, she's bleeding again. Whoops. I'd make a nice doctor. A broken piece of denture. Patient might want this back. There it goes.
Drift away.
We can pretend this is the boss's colonoscopy. You would trust me inside your ass? In the gastroenterology profession, we don't call it the ass. We have a little more tact. About to gastro-enter you, by the way. What the fuck? Oh, it's the ring. Music is stopping. It's her lost treasure. Taffy? Ancient piece of chewing gum permanently stuck to the colon. I was wondering if this game, like, wanted to be taken seriously a little bit or something. But I don't think it does. I think it's just being silly. You can swallow chewing gum. Unless you have, like, really bad bowels, and, you know, don't swallow anything questionable, because anything can get stuck. If you eat nothing but mac and cheese and, like, Hot Pockets, you shouldn't swallow things that you can't digest. Hey, man, cauterize that shit. Snip it. Clip it.
No woe, but that the prediction was for, today was a good day.
That's what I've been saying all day, man. The prediction's for the entire stream, so I could have made it last for like 25 minutes, but I thought I might woe, so, you know, why do that, right? Well, this brings in a lot of viewers, huh? You guys like to see old granny's assholes? That's pretty awesome. Maybe it's a little cat sleeping. After you rinsed off Mr. and Mrs. Hargreaves ring, you watched with delight as she slid it back onto her finger. You will be telling colleagues, friends, and relatives about Mrs. Hargreaves for years to come. Good anecdotes are hard to come by. You went to bed chuckling to yourself until you fell asleep feeling happy. This was the last normal day.
Well, why would you ruin that?
Normal. She had teeth in her butt. That's not normal. Pica? I think that's what fucking Opie has. Stupid bastards always trying to eat plastic.
There's some donuts.
It's uncommon for someone as young as you.
Colonoscopy.
When I saw your x-ray, I was quite shocked. Could not distinguish what was happening inside your large intestine. You guys hear that? I think something's on fire. For over a year, I suffered from a condition known as pica.
Like Zoink Scoop, I crave to eat things that are not food!
That sounds like Shaggy. Started off harmlessly, I would eat the eraser and my pencils. I would do that, but I wouldn't eat it. I would just chew it. I would eat small bits of paper, small bits of plastic from food packaging. Yeah, this is real shit. I cannot remember everything I ate, but I do know I ate a lot of different things. Recently began to crave metallic items. I began eating small coins, paper clips, small screws, steel nails. I was hospitalized after I collapsed at work. Surgeons removed 30 objects from my stomach. I saw a fucking headline, a news headline that said, man has to go, is hospitalized after eating 600 nails. And there were x-rays to go with it of literally, like, 600 nails in his stomach. And the comment on the website had, like, the most views or whatever. Just said, imagine sitting down and eating 500 nails and thinking, you know what I could really go for right now? 100 more nails.
How do you fit 600 nails in you? There was that guy called the Gray Man. What was his name? I forget. He was the one who used to kill and rape and eat kids. When they did his autopsy after they killed him or whatever, he had like a bunch of pins and nails in his pelvis that he hammered into himself just because he liked it, and they found them in him, and they're like, what the hell? Yeah, Albert Fish, that's who it is. I read his entire Wikipedia page because I was so interested. When he was asked about why he kidnapped minority children more than white children, he said it's because no one would miss them. He was like, no one's going to make a big search party for like a little black girl. That's why I did it. And I was like, holy shit. Who thinks about stuff like that? Are you still having these cravings? He's going to try and eat my metal instruments. Oh, it's a woman. They're in the hospital because of malnutrition and they're having money troubles. It's because you keep eating your own moolah. Not had any cravings since the treatment started. That is fantastic. I wish you continued recovery. Thank you. Now, open your ass. It will do things slowly and methodically. Carefully remove all the remaining objects from your bowel. So you can go back to living a normal life. Tsubarashi. This game's grossing me out. Need a little temperament adjustment. Ah, another day on the job, huh? If you looked inside my colon, find nothing. You'd find nothing but perfectly sculpted spherical shits like a rabbit and video scripts and pica. Pica's not funny. That shit must suck. Only like 20 years ago we were exploiting people with pica and making TLC shows about them. Little Jenny eats 500 pieces of foam mattress a day. Look at this stupid bitch. 55-minute episode of this poor woman who has a horrible condition. Doctor saying, stop it, you idiot, stop. Can I scan the walls? Maybe take her foam mattress away? Yeah, dude. That expertise... You're into gastroenterology, bustology, aren't you? She'll just go get another mattress. What do you think happens, dude? These people have problems. She's just gonna go buy another mattress. You gotta put them in rehab. I like that Grand Blue Fantasy Versus gif of Vera holding her face. It says, God, I can't stop eating. Oh boy. I'm such a fucking idiot. I saw the darkness on the right there when you moved the camera, and I thought, no, there's another turn I can go. Like, there's gonna be multiple passageways. It's the colon. Alright, let me get the gripper.
Yoink!
Oop, that went pretty far. Looking at old Library of Alexandria coins like this, coins from the time period.
look at them on the auction sites go for like $160. I want one so bad, I don't know why. I'm getting old, man. Oh. Getting old, I want to collect coins. This is going to be an arduous journey. Oh my god. Alright, let's get the gripper out. These are just metal shavings or something. Said that she was craving something metallic. It's my cat with plastic. I'm expediting this process. I'm a wonderful doctor. Oops, my door. And you know I'm on the other end, making them feel good and safe, too. This game's gonna give me a bad ending. It fell through the floor. The metal shaving fell through the floor. Oh well. It is what it is, right? Thin shaving of metal. This stuff wouldn't even get stuck in my ass, it would just come out perfectly. Oh, cool! It's fireworks. Happy New Year's, fellas. Came in so clutch with all she came over before. I already told you guys, but she came over before Christmas, like just before we're about to go to my sister's place, and she's just carrying mounds and bags of shit into my house, and she's like, well, I don't know if you want this or not. I have brown rice and white rice, and do you eat black-eyed peas? And I'm like, Grandma, you're giving me free food. I will eat any of this shit. He's like, okay, I just want to make sure you have enough provisions. She gave me a bunch of canned corn, a bunch of canned peas. I'm just like, whatever, good, awesome, I'll take it. That's what I said to her. I said, shit, Graham, you come in clutch. I said, you come in clutch, Graham. Yeah, she's a grandma. She loves places like Goodwill. I think that's probably where she gets it. Although some of it was just great value. She got me a bunch of, like, dry split peas that I've never even cooked with. I'll just throw them in a soup or something. Truly, these are the last of our days. cold days. I know they're counting down. I'm thinking about them too much. I'm thinking about the cool, crisp air so much that it'll be over. I'm not paying attention to them. I'm thinking about them too much. I'm counting them down. I need to just enjoy them. Because soon it will be over. Because I put water on it. Yeah, I mean, I think that's pretty obvious. My grandma's always trying to pay for shit, too. And I hate when people pay for me with stuff, so naturally I'm opposed to it. She gets more and more aggressive now. She's like, no, we'll do that. I remember the last time I was coming back from her house. Or second to last time, maybe. Past a fresh market. And she was like, do you need anything? And I was just making conversation. I wasn't trying to get her to stop. It wasn't even there, I swear. She made it materialize out of fucking thin air. She was like, do you need anything? I said, no, I got stuff. I have enough stuff to, like, make food. Just a little low on eggs. Meowm! Before I could even finish the sentence. Meowm! Pulled into a parking lot. Made it appear out of thin fucking air. I was like, What? This was never here. Filled my refrigerator up with eggs. Alright. You know what? You're right. You're right, Grandpa. You're right. When you're right, you're right. I think that part was supposed to be scary because there was a weird music, but I was talking about my grandma, so I didn't want to stop. Oh my god. Well, it's a dirty job, but someone's gotta do it. Am I gonna make him fucking bleed out if I do this without cauterizing? Okay. Why am I getting scared? All right. Get out of her butt. Oh, missed one. I'm already not gonna get a perfect because of that one. The one metal shaving that went into the colonoscopy back rooms. The Lord of the Rings, the Fellowship of the Ring, and Lord of the Rings, the Two Towers, and the Lord of the Rings, the Return of the King, all the extended cut, and 3 days with my friends. I didn't really want to, I wasn't feeling it, but they insisted, and I was like, alright, I mean, if you're gonna watch Lord of the Rings, I'm not gonna not fucking be there. It was pretty good. I will say this, though. I think that the extended cuts of Lord of the Rings, which everyone insists on watching, are leagues worse than the theatrical editions. Every time, whenever you watch Lord of the Rings, everyone's like, oh, is this you don't have the extended cut. You got the wrong one. It's like, no, it's not the wrong one. It seems like a bunch of deleted scenes that they said, ah, well, we can repackage this and put the deleted scenes in. So that, you know, they're getting something new. Because they don't have... More than half of the extended edition scenes that are, like, new to the movie completely fuck up the pacing. Or just reiterate something that's already been said. Or, like, a character development that's already been made. Because that's another thing that people will say. They're like, oh, no, they're good for character development. It's like... Some of them are just dog shit, man. Like, total dog shit. Just completely ruins the pace. Like, I'm not a... What the hell is that? Oh, battery. Spicy metal. Yummy. Yeah, anytime people want to watch it. And then it's like, Return of the King is the worst in the trilogy. I'm going to say that. Boom. The best one is The Fellowship. It's the most cohesive adventure story. And it... The Return of the King one is like literally like 4 hours and 20 minutes long. And whenever the extra scenes come on, I immediately go into critical analytical mode. Like, okay, let's see what this scene does for the movie. The Return of the King had some. Like, it really answered some of the questions with, like, the ghost army, I guess. But mostly, it was just, you don't have to do this. A lot of the extra scenes are just there for comedic effect. And nothing else. And the comedic effect isn't that great because it's not that funny. There's a lot of extra scenes with Gimli just being stupid. It's like, we already had enough of those. We know he's kind of loopy, that's it. Don't make him like the actual joke character even more. I kind of feel the same way about... There's one cut of Apocalypse Now where they have sex with the supermodels at the Air Force Base with the at the helicopter. And I think that really detracts from the film. I don't think that's a good addition to Apocalypse Now. It's not interesting, it's not what... It feels like it's out of place, it's just, eh. I don't like that part. Maybe there's a reason why the theatrical editions are as they are. Not that, you know, big executives having control and telling you to take parts out of your film or anything out of your writing, out of your music, isn't complete and utter AIDS. But I think they're, you know, at some point you gotta be like, hey, there's a reason why this wasn't in the movie. Well, the good news is this lady doesn't have any polyps or calcium deposits. In fact, she's quite healthy. If it weren't for the nails. Luckily, that's a problem that takes care of itself over time. If you just don't eat the nails. Yeah, that's what I was thinking this whole time. It's like the centipede chase, like chapter 12 or whatever from DMC3. You can kill that guy. The giant tapeworm. What if you guys had a tapeworm and it was like a record length? But it was so big that it's... one of its little heads popped out of your butthole, and the other one just sat in the back near your uvula. So before you could even chew up your burger, he's just there taking bites. And you fell in love with him, and you were like, no, don't hurt him. Like, that's my little homie. Now, this is self-harm. I mean, this is all self-harm, but... Like, this one, this had to have been intentional. That could not have looked that yummy. You gotta know what that is. What is this frickin' thing? Metal spring? Barbed wire? Is that what this is? It's barbed wire. Get stuck again or anything. I'm starting to not give a fuck about this cauterization at the end. I wish not to leave my patients in any anal anguish. I will cauterize their wounds. Is that what I'm supposed to tell her? I get this far in, I just tell her, lady, you're dead. Huh, what? Oh, it got stuck in the wall again. Oh, I guess it didn't. Big fan of the gripper. Sort of relaxing, huh? I like it. We've been in this lady's asshole for a minute. Why indie game have bad graphic? The world may never know. Yeah, it's starting to look like she actually ate an entire barbed wire burger. And obviously she found more than one razor blade. Thought that would be a good call. She ate the first razor blade and said, ow! Spicy. Oops. Maybe that's what she actually had to do. She doesn't want to tell anyone because it was such a traumatic experience. She was in a jigsaw trap. She was in Saw 7.
So before you was a pile of nails. Wait, what are you doing? I didn't tell you what you're doing. Wait, stop eating them. What are you doing? Oh my god, you ate all 600 nails. Fuck, you could go. You could go. Just leave.
If this game has a cheap fucking jump scare of like a tapeworm or something that just comes out and goes after lulling me into this false sense of security, I'm gonna be so ticked. Go! Get out of here! Go! I think that what we're learning from this game is that being a doctor is, I mean, to be honest, it's easy. I don't like the look of what's ahead. Eternal darkness. I probably shouldn't drink a... What the fuck? A shotgun shell. could have been a doctor if I went to college. You don't have to go to college to be a doctor. You just set up shop. You just set up shop and you look at other doctors' prices and you go, well, that's exorbitant. You just lower yours. You operate, you get the shit done, and then you say, yeah, just don't tell anyone. And then it works. This must be removed very carefully. I mean, that's as careful as I can do it. I'm just gonna shoot it with water. I don't want to have to do this all over again. I don't want to do this all over again. Oh, fuck! All right, it did exactly what I thought it would. I couldn't stop myself. Time to do that all over again. I realized my mistake instantly. The demons got to me. You attempted admirably to stop the bleeding, but the damage was too extensive. An investigation into her death was opened. You plan to cooperate fully. Every time you think about what happened, you vomit. Yeah, it was... Oh! Catastrophic lack of judgment led to a negative patient outcome. Was that a whoa? Did I say whoa or did I just... Oh. Hidden cargo? Hey, it went on to the next day. We don't have to do it again.
Whoopsie!
Okay, there's gonna be fish hooks in his asshole. That's awesome. Let me go shut my windows because I'm screaming now and talking about buttholes nonstop.
Hungry. I'm gonna make a potato soup with a nice stock.
And I'm gonna add some spices. I have so many chilies that I bought that I still haven't used yet. I'm gonna use these Hungarian chilies I got. Oh, you know what? I might do curry. I might just do curry. I like how at any time when you're making a soup, you can look at it and go, I've done this before. Have you guys done this? You'll be making a soup or something? Or like even a stir fry. Sometimes I'll be making a stir fry or a soup and I go, oh wait, I want curry. You just throw in some curry and some coconut milk. It's like, there you go. It's as easy as pie. Every day I go out to sea and return with what nature gives me. Every time I eat, I come to sea. It is a cold, lonely, and often dangerous life that requires a lot of strength. Recently, I feel like my strength is slowly being sucked away. I become tired before I pull in the first cage. I feel hungry all the time, even after eating a big... Oh, we got tapeworm. Losing a lot of weight, which scares me the most. We got a tapeworm. I've always been overweight. In the last few months, my weight has gone down by over a third. I'm worried I will waste away to nothing. So that everything you eat comes from the sea, yes. Are you eating fish straight from the sea without cooking it? Yes. It is so fresh, there's no need to cook it. You know they can have... It really sucks. Right now, I think parasites and mercury poisoning and a lot of other issues are at an all-time high with sea creatures. I think sustainable farming fish is a really good idea, but sometimes you just can't stop them from spreading disease and parasites. It's ridiculous. I've eaten like this for many years, and I've never had a problem. People with parasites may not always show symptoms until the parasites are large in number or in size. It can take a while for them to grow and reproduce. I suppose you may be right. I do get weird feelings in my gut sometimes. I feel things twitching and moving about. Moving about. Yes, the feeling I get in my guts reminds me of what I see every day. A writhing pile of fish. Oh, I am sure it is nothing like that at all. There's only one way to find out. Make yourself comfortable and we shall begin. Make yourself comfortable? I tell you what, boy, I got an anus like a vice grip. If I ever had to get a colonoscopy or any kind of prostate exam, my doctor would be like, loosen up, will ya? My doctor would be like, what, you want like a drink or something? I want some whiskey I got on my desk? I'd say, hell yeah! And I'd start fighting him. I'd be like, why you got your fingers in there? Hey, you fuck! Hey! Alright, let's see what you got. That is, I don't know. Oh no, do we have our first case of poop? I don't want to see poop. Yeah. Oh! Piece of excrement, but not from a human. Good. We can continue playing the game. That's you guys. Speaking of doctors, that's what the doctor said when you were born. Look at this inhuman piece of excrement. Then he pinched your little cheeks like this. He said, this inhuman, this alien fecal filth. You don't even get to name him Mother. I will name him. I am your doctor. For all you know, I am your god. Could have let this little rascal wriggle around inside of you an extra minute and hang himself on his own umbilical cord, and I let him live this inhuman filth. He will be known henceforth as Twitch Chad. Just a polyp. Game for like people who play. Oh, see, if you wash them and like, I think this counts. I think they're moving. I think they just got stuck. I don't really care though anymore. I did my best, whatever. You know, not all poop flushes. I'm gonna watch Goodfellas with the boys tonight, assuming any of them show up. It's gonna be epic. It's gonna be freaking epic. Goodfellas on New Year's, and I'm gonna quote the whole movie and be annoying. I might even drink some beer. What's the best Christmas movie? I don't know. Tokyo Godfathers, maybe? This also could just be a New Year's movie. What the fuck? Oh, they're ticks! I know what to do here. Gotta get the gripper. Hey, you little bastard! This game just became so based.
Motherfucker dead.
Time to pop these chunky monkeys. You guys see that the new slur just dropped? You guys seen the viral video of the guy playing Shadow of the Colossus for the first time? And the weird little, the shadow creatures pop up and he goes, "Oh, get out of here!" And they fade away and he says, "Get out of here, smoke monkeys!" It's like, what? That's what they are. They're smoke monkeys.
Those are pig noises. These things are making pig noises.
I wonder if you, like, get a penalty if you don't, cauterize fast enough. I don't really know. I'm starting to think not. I'm starting to think that these people have unlimited blood. You know what I've been really craving? A really fun arcade-y shooter. So, I've already beaten Doom Eternal, or not Doom Eternal, Doom 2016, but I was going through some shit when I played that game, so I didn't play it with you guys, I just played it alone. And I really enjoyed that game. That was a long time ago, so I thought maybe I could play that on stream. I've already beaten it, so I'll play it on hard or something. Or we can just skip to Doom Eternal, but see, people seem to be pretty split on that game, whether or not it's, like, a good game. Your ammo's hard to come by. Another successful operation. They're just distorted pig noises. Has none of his own poop because the ticks keep eating him. What is this one again? You're just a polyp. I don't know if I have ultra kill. It's possible. Brother in Christ. These aren't even oceanic parasites. They're fucking wood ticks. They're deer ticks. What is that? Oh, is that a piece of tick? Unidentifiable piece of flesh.
This guy eats meat? Meat is murder!
Sorry. killer's a first-person shooter.
Tickle, tickle.
I should leave a couple to remind him of his sins. Eat real food, kids. If you see high fructose corn syrup, canola oil, and dyes like Red 40, stay away. Maybe have that as a treat. Eat Borgli. Big Broccoli paying me off again. Broccoli and egg, haha. Oh, I stopped eating pasta every single day and just eating vegetables and protein. Why do I feel so good? Ew! Well, those are just mealworms. Now, this doesn't even make any sense. This doesn't make any sense either. What the fuck are these doing here? Should I grip these? Oh, God. What happens if I cauterize them? I had a very strange dream last night. There wasn't anything particularly strange about the dream aside from the fact that I was the one having it, because usually my dreams are never very good. But I had a dream that I had a different job, and I took it very seriously, and I was very passionate about it. I was working at Well, I guess it was still kind of scary. My brain wouldn't allow it to be, like, too normal. You guys know, like, that guy on YouTube who has the underground eel pit? And he has sturgeons in it? Probably see him on TikTok or something. I had a dream that I worked at an underground station like that, except it was a bunch of interconnected cement aquarium-like places. And they were all connected by a river system. And you had to walk on stepping stones to get to each one. And I had to go by and feed and take care of all the fish and everything. Of course, when that happens, there always has to be an alligator or a shark coming close to biting me. That never does, but yeah, I had to like feed a bunch of sharks. But I took it very seriously, and then also I think I had to like... I think I ran their social media page, and no one... This is the part that interests me the most, is that there was no one who cared about their social media page. It's like many businesses, right? So I would take pictures of, fish, and I'd say, Teddy had to take his vitamins today, and he was very nice about it. And it's like a picture of a little hammerhead shark with, an infection in his eye. I don't know. And then it got like 2 or 3 likes on Facebook. And I was delighted by it, which is weird to me because if I want likes, I can just go get them anywhere. I don't have to be clever. I don't have to try. I can tweet butt itches and then, it'll just be like, all right, 100 people like that. But I was delighted by the notion that there were 4 people who really enjoyed that Teddy's treatment went well. I don't know. So now his dream made me think, man. What the fuck are these? Am I supposed to? Oh, these are fish bones. They are the fish de bona. De bona de fish. In Africa, we drink the bone.
We eat the bone. We drink the child blood.
In high school, they called me maggot ass. That looks like a potato. Not done yet. God's name. An egg sac looks full. Removal of this to prevent further strip. Okay. You wanna get grabbed? Have I ever seen something so disgusting that it made me lightheaded? Maybe not disgusting, but you know, everyone's affected by different things in different ways. There's some things that stick with me really bad. All clean. Do you think at any point during the creation of this game, the dev was like, what am I doing? Fuck outta here. I'm just gonna cut this one. Awesome. I'm gonna fucking kill this guy on accident. What? That one cried like a baby. We are the monsters. Bad graphic make it hard to see. Where's the actual issue? There it is. Helping him. This is just like when Wook entered the Death Star. My frame of reference is nothing but Harry Potter and Star Wars and Lord of the Rings. You could probably trick an old lady into thinking this game's educational and get her to play it until there's a jump scare, and then she would die. You're saying, have you seen something so disgusting that's made you lightheaded? I don't know about that. I did see a video the other day of some teenager in line at like a Walgreens or something. Some old lady walked up behind him and I guess just got too close to him and he punched her in the face and she just fell over. Like she had to have been like 70 or something. Stuff like that makes me want to kill that guy. Oops. I'm helping you. I'm helping you. I don't give a fuck about the blood no more. Hey, yo, what little blood up to? Whatever, bleed, man, bleed. I don't give a shit. Bleed forever. Yeah, you can lose in this game. I just detonated a buckshot in some woman's butthole because she ate it. Becoming exemplary at this. A jolly good show. You are relieved of your duty, parasitic excrement. This guy showed me his butthole and said, just a little off the top, please. Said, alright, I'm a professional. Thought might get struck, all the music is copyrighted. If you were here to live it, you were here to live it! Woohoo! Time to pog on the bodies. Clip, computer, play clip number 3.
A resolution? Airstrike. Bomb them. Bomb them. Pink bomb them. Bomb them again.
This guy cannot have another asshole. Oh my god. 3 of them? Hey, yo, what little blood doing? Black people say that a lot. I watch a lot of fight videos on Twitter. And like, it's like someone gets sucker punched really hard and then cracks their skull on the pavement. It looks like they're having like a fucking aneurysm. There are people in the comments who will say, like, oh man, that's fucked up. That guy should go to jail for what he did. There's always someone responding to that saying, ah, jit'll be alright. It's like, are you fucking blind? Some people see someone get hit in the head and fall down, and they just think, like everything that they've known in life tells them that means that that person is just sleeping. Do you have any idea how life-changing it can be to, like, slip and fall in a parking lot? Let alone someone uppercutting your skull. Then they get a couple extra kicks into your, the bridge of your nose. He only kick him twice, jit'll be alright. What the fuck? Kawaii. Will these hurt me? Rhizopods.
guy outside can see him on the TV and he goes, no, don't kill them, no!
An aquatic blood-sucking louse. This cannot be left in the golden.
Okay. Time to die. He's pigging out.
That's a visual. Hold on, let me get a screenshot.
What happens if you take the gripper?
Okay, goodbye.
Ain't no thing for this, John. Jit'll be all right. Hey, yo, what little blood doing?
I think Devilman Crybaby is good for New Year's as well. I'd watch that on New Year's. You are Umaso. That's a good one for New Year's. Rain in the New Year. With some Dino Square Kino. I am feeling catharsis. Where are they going now? This is a long game. Long colon.
The dev should make another one of these, but for the Vajanka. That'd be funny, am I right? That'd be funny. That'd be funny. They show the Vajanka a little bit. That'd be good.
That's a fish. Dude, King Leonidas. What gets the donos?
What the fuck?
Abortion successful. Flush this inhuman excrement. This is what Joseph Biden would have wanted. This guy's got pica too, apparently. Alright, are these gonna continue to make baby noises at me? That's amazing.
This is kind of Kino, bros. I kind of like this. Holy shit. Away with ye! You don't have a soul yet. Get out of the colon.
I should go into politics. I'd be the realest motherfucker there ever was. And then they'd assassinate me. I'd assassinate myself. I'd be winning with 51% of the vote. And I'd get up on stage. It's like 7 days left. And I'd say, "This fucking country doesn't deserve a president like me!" And I blow my fucking head off. I go, "Are you guys gonna vote for Kanye if he runs? Next year, boys, we get to talk about politics. It's gonna be so epic, it's gonna be so cool. I'm gonna vote for him. I'm not gonna listen to anything that he has to say. I'm just gonna vote for him." The fuck is that? A cheese? Oh, that's a... I'm a little hungry. Oh, I did it. The treasurer. I found it. Finally. After all these years, the G-spot does exist. That was it. . 100%. Where are the fireworks? Someone threw firecrackers out at like 6 a.m. this morning and woke me up. What are they doing, a test run? They're fucking firecrackers. Never seen a parasite infestation as bad as this. Biological waste bag that contains the extracted parasites undulates as it sits on your lap. The fisherman was shocked to see what came out of him. Perhaps he will cook his food from now on. Left your office looking a bit shocked and weak. But you knew in a few hours he should feel much better. You sent numerous specimens to the lab for analysis. Perhaps you have discovered a new species. At home that evening, you sit with a Latin dictionary and look for interesting words to use for new parasite names. Your wife cooks you spaghetti, but you cannot eat it without retching. Instead, you sit on the sofa and eat ice cream from the tub. No, I don't. You hope tomorrow will be a boring day. This was made by like a Swede or something, wasn't it? That's a fucking guess in the wind right there. Someone, chat, look it up. Seems Swedish to me. Scandinavian, at least. I really liked Cry of Fear. I was watching a video on, like, video game Easter eggs at fucking 3 a.m. the other day. And they brought up Cry of Fear and how it was difficult to get, like, the true ending. And that's the one that I got. Just out of sheer luck. Because you have to kill the carcass boss. And then you have to give the gun to the doctor. And that's like one of the things you have to do. Uh-oh. Patient Norwood, you can probably tell by my appearance that I enjoy eating food. Oh, Swiss. Close enough. If one of these assholes ends up having like a branching path, that would be so funny. My job is to write about food and restaurants. Though I would not class myself as a critic because I am rarely disappointed by food. My favorite type of food is barbecue. I've written more words about barbecue than on any other subject. Ouch. You look like you are in severe pain. Yes, the pain in my bowels is terrible. It is as if my bowels are getting excited at the prospect of more food and demanding that I eat. That's a tapeworm. That is not exactly how it works, but I can feel it.
I can feel it. I hear something in my mind demanding more food.
It grips me from within and knows that I am in pain. The pain stops when I give it food. It controls me. Yeah, neighbor, you're fat. That's it. That's the whole thing, brother. Cannot say that I've ever encountered any symptoms like these in medical literature. You're probably insane. I can see you are suffering, and I want to stop it. I think we should get started immediately. Arigato. Oh, I think my package arrived. I got a sweet package. You guys wash your hands after you receive a package. I do. That shit has exchanged so many strangers' hands and been so many dirty places. I can't stand it.
Think about washing my hands after I touch doorknobs outside too. Especially if I'm, like, going grocery shopping. First thing I do when I get home is wash my hands.
You think it sounds like autism? Am I really someone you want to mess with right now? And you think it sounds like I'm in your ass? Would you say it was? Would you say it sounds like? Say it again. How does that make you feel?
Tickles.
What the fuck? What?
Oh, okay.
Human eyeball that appears to be rooted inside the colon. Remove it so it can be analyzed.
Okay, that's fine. Just don't make a blood fountain.
What? How the hell? Thanks.
Just another day on the job.
Things get a little weird.
So what?
No residue to clean it either. It's good.
Okay, well, this guy is eating people.
Or like you said, maybe it's 99 insight. Those are teeth.
Not scary. I'm no scare. I'm no scare of no thing. No scare of me. No.
Like pulling teeth from a baby.
Obviously, his game's not that gross. I'm fucking eating while doing it.
Hummus should be made pretty much the same way. You know, you should have lemon juice and tahini and, you know, chickpeas, whatever. Olive oil. But I'm telling you right now, I think that if you chop up some raw habanero, really, really finely dice it up and put it in, it adds such a nice, like, almost fruity flavor to your hummus. It's delicious. It's my favorite thing to put in hummus. Habanero is a very nice pepper. I don't use it enough. Been using serrano chilies a lot lately. That and these Hungarian finger chilies that I got. None of which are that spicy. My spice tolerance, over the past, I'll say, 3 years now, has just gone through the fucking roof. Actual flavor, unlike jalapeno. What the fuck are you smoking, man? It does have a flavor, but jalapeno is a fantastic flavor. Jalapeno I like because I think people mistake jalapeno as like an ingredient to be used only for Hispanic cuisine. But the truth is, jalapeno can go in anything, and it will instantly make it better. You have a soup. You have a stir fry? A curry? Put some jalapeno in it. I think the two ingredients for whenever I do make miso soup now, my two ingredients that I think are indispensable, you know, aside from what you have to put in to make it miso, are, I like very, very, very thinly sliced jalapeno and mushroom. And then I put them in at the end of cooking for like 1 minute, I blanch them. So they're just barely not raw. But they're still, like, you know, fresh. So nice with a miso soup. I don't eat a lot of miso soup anymore because, you know, it's so salty. And the probiotic benefits I get from everything else that I eat. I eat a lot of fermented sauerkraut. I'm a slut for kimchi lately. I eat a lot of yogurt. So, all that salt I kind of don't need because I already get enough salt from all the pickled stuff that I eat. So I need to set up a day and have some miso because I used to make it like once a week. You guys are making me hungry, boy. It's funnier, the older you get, the more you just talk about food. You start to really appreciate food.
This carrot tastes like shit. I don't think this guy is eating people. I think his colon is eating him.
Sauerkraut for repopulating the gut fauna to killing it with alcohol.
True.
The issue with that is that alcohol also destroys your mucus lining in your stomach after repeated days of drinking. So, when you do reintroduce gut fauna, the mucus lining isn't there to protect them, and a lot of it, most of it will die, and your stomach acid. Moral of the story, point to an organ in the body, and I'll tell you how alcohol affects it, because it does. And it's never good. Anytime you have any issue with your body, a doctor can just be like, do you drink a lot? Okay, that's it. It can be any place on the body. Yeah, alcohol will do that too.
What the hell? Alcohol gives you cancer?
Oh yeah, it can.
Wow. What can't it do?
What a marvelous product. I think I'll have some more. Everyone brings up the liver with alcohol. Liver's the last thing you gotta worry about.
I mean, it's not true, but
it'll affect everything. At least the liver regenerates, right?
These are alive.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, some red wine is good for you. A beer a day isn't even bad for you. You know, allegedly. Keep in mind, I'm not a nutritionist, and whenever people talk about nutrition, that it affects everyone differently, so. There's no end-all, be-all, like, cure for being a healthy individual. But there are general rules. That's why I say to you guys, just eat real food. That's a general rule. He's good for you.
He's good for you and he's tasty.
Oh man, this is getting weird. I think this is the finger reveal music and I walked away. Stumps, let's go. I wasn't planning on playing this for that long. I gotta cook my soup here soon. Sniped. And I wash and wash and wash and wash and wash, but the blood never comes off. Thank you for the gift subs, Mister. Sorry for not streaming so much. I've been going through it. It's counterproductive too. Oxymoronic, whatever you want to say. Streaming makes me happy. I've been having a couple unhappy days. So you think you'd stream more.
Sometimes it don't work that way.
Bad things happen sometimes.
Sucks shit, man.
Can I get another bad phone call?
My life is bad phone calls.
Thingy time.
Again, I ask, am I on the other side of the butthole just pulling these guys out? Is the guy bent over saying, what is it? I'm going, nothing, it's nothing. I'm calling the cops with my third hand. No, it's nothing, it's fine, this is very normal. What's normal? Shut up. What is it, though?
Oh, doctor. Oh, stop it. Oh, doctor, you nasty. Hey. Give me the phalange.
You little fucker. You ruined my speed run.
No, I tried to pop the corn with the laser earlier. I do not believe it worked. There's something wrong with that guy. Am I patient? No. Me? No. Maybe you should look within yourself to find your own answers. What's wrong with you? I'm not a therapist, but I'll take advantage of you.
Sneaky corn, you saw it.
I almost missed it. Or lost my 100%.
I'm not scanning. Well, there's nothing to scan. I scanned the teeth already. I didn't scan the ear.
Cool soundtrack. I'm gonna have a fucking boss fight or something. Huh? Is this a tulip? Oh no, I think it's a carnivorous tooth. These teeth kind of look like the tooth prop that Bowen has in Dragonheart after he slays the one dragon off stream. And he's shaking it around, and it's got like a little nub on the back. He says, "Honor won't feed my belly, no shoe my horse, nor shoe my horse." That's what it... Jig, Dragonheart. Again, landing the dragon. I didn't name Dagnum. Drag.
To the stars, bro.
The dragon. My dementia-ridden streamer. Wish you guys had more endearing terms for me as your streamer. Like, how about my honeysuckle sugar plum streamer? Kissy wissy off to pissy streamer. Guard girl, my sweet fruit, donates $500. I don't want to cauterize this shit, man. It takes too fucking long, dude. This guy can have a few punctures. And look what's in him. It can take a lot, obviously. I'll stream Crash Bandicoot 4 eventually. You get to play as Dingo Dial in that game, so it's immediately based.
Dingo Dial. Alright, fucking rip that cunt.
Is this anal for? Yeah, whatever, man. Whatever you want it to be, that's it. Sure. Go to the library. Don't take the stream with you. Go to the market, little piggy. Carrot's done. Just gotta flush the fragments into my colon. Oh. I got ashwagandha and a probiotic. I don't wanna drink them. I'm gonna shuck them. Me healthy. Hello, Opie. Jizzes on your rectal cavity. Whoops. My mistake. You're not gonna have a good time tonight. when those bombs over Baghdad start going off, I'm gonna start screaming. This game has more backtracking than DMC4. Raises at the desk. I need to hurry this up because I know you guys are going somewhere fancy tonight. Well, you guys are going to a big party.
Not really. Tickle, tickle. Hey, cheer up, sport.
Sorry? The fuck is that?
Huh?
Oh. Cool! Oh, it's him! It's his face! His colon is becoming him. You want I should scan that? Cool! A small version of our patient's head. It is growing from within the colon. It is demanding food. Okay. Job well done. Oh, there's another one. Oh, I think that's just a piece.
Jit'll be alright, he get over it. What is John doing? Hey, little blood. Hey, little blood up in his rectum. What little Jit doing in his bit his poo-poo place?
There's nothing in the medical literature that explains what you just saw. After it was all over, your patient's demeanor had changed completely. Stood up straight with a big smile on his face. He thanked you profusely and left your office, looking like a new man. Cleared the rest of the day's schedule and went home early. You went with your wife to your favorite park for a nice stroll. Afterwards, you both sat on a bench by the lake and fed the ducks. You are glad tomorrow is Friday. It's probably the last one. Oh, the Minnesota Vikings playing 30 minutes against the Green Bay Packers. Friday. What will Friday's ass bring? That's what I've been saying.
It's not time for you to eat, but oh, I guess it is, actually. You want to eat? Opa, Sima? Sima, come here. Sima.
Friday the blockage. Time to perform another Twitch chat abortion. My bowels feel very strange and uncomfortable, like I have something stuck inside of me. Let me show you guys something. I'm gonna show you two things. Oops, not that. Oops, not
that. Where did I fucking put it? I found it.
Okay, guys, check this out. It's gonna be so fucking sick. It's gonna be so fucking sick, man. It's gonna be so fucking sick.
Oh, whoops, I already opened it. No more Revenge of the Colon right now. We gotta watch this awesome, what is it? That's not me and Michael, man. That's me and Michael. Alright, how do we do this? I've done this a million times.
Nice! Looking fucking sick, my dudes.
Amazon game. Hold on. Just always put this shit too fucking... A world for sorcerers. A world for anal polyps. What happened in this game? I guess it's thriving. Unless.
Wow.
Wait, that was it? They said look at it for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. What the fuck do you want me to do for the... What else am I... What am I supposed to do? Talk about it? Hammer. Purple. Stones. Amazon. Subscription fee. RPG fun game and fish. Feels good to sit, my laddies. Oh, it feels good to sit. Why did the viewership go up by like 100? You don't want to look at New World? Hold on, let me do this one now. Oops. I barely streamed, so I gotta get the corpo money. Now we're gonna watch another one. Look at this one. This one's cool, too. I assume. This one's cool, too.
assume. Alright, check this out.
Everyone.
Why is it always so loud? Why do they use this website? What is this, Dropbox?
Need your attention, please. I'm gonna burn this place to the ground.
Oh no, it's a Jason Statham movie.
You're a blessing, Mr. Clay. This place was
a beekeeper.
Back to life.
And then they killed his nanny.
She was like family. She was the only person who ever took care of me.
Oh, wait, that's actually what happened.
I just got a message saying that there's a problem with my computer.
Yes, ma'am, we got this.
Yesterday, she shot herself.
This is private property.
Do you know what they do here?
Hello, sir, do they do that?
Buddy, I'm counting to three.
One, two, three.
What the fuck? Did he really just do that?
I did it for you. I'm gonna burn this place to the ground.
It's another trailer where they take an older song and then they just put some bass drops in it.
You're telling me one man did this?
It's a Nine Inch Nails song.
The only thing you know is he's a beekeeper.
A beekeeper? A beekeeper?
Well, that's not good.
Beekeepers is a subtle program outside the chain of command.
I protect the hive. When the system is out of balance,
I correct it.
We have laws for these things.
Until they fail, then you have me.
My fingers, they cut them off.
Oh, what the fuck, bro?
Don't move.
That's kind of cool. It's kind of funny. Well, the bounty only wants me to watch this for a minute and 59 seconds, which I have. And I don't want to ruin the rest of the movie, because I know there's a lot of you who are looking forward to it. So, we end the tracking there. It's quite triple, really. Oh, man. Something's in my ass. Problem has become worse over the past week. I hope it's not a tumor or anything like that. I felt perfectly fine until a week ago. Think that's a bunch of protein powder in the back? I'm jealous. I got protein powder recently. It's like zero sugar and has stevia in it. I don't know how anyone falls for that stevia stuff. Aspartame, stevia. There's so many different sweeteners, and then everyone says, no, stevia is the one that comes from a leaf. It's fine for you. It's like, it all tastes like shit. Like, it has such a distinct taste. You must be really addicted to sugar or, like, soda to convince yourself that a diet soda tastes good. A diet pop. Your butt doctor would never prescribe you protein powder. Yeah, you'd be fucking liquid shitting. They'd need your business. They need you to come in. They need you to have stuff get stuck. They'd be like, you should eat more red meat and fuck off with the carrots. No more carrots. In fact, no more vegetables. Those razor blades you were eating are actually packed full of iron. That's not that bad.
The risk is worth the reward.
Do you chew your food sufficiently? Yes, of course. I have mostly eaten soup in the past week. Base. And peanuts. Wait, what the fuck? He's literally me. I work in the circus with elephants. I have access to a lot of peanuts.
Do you eat an unusually large quantity of peanuts? Holy fuck. Only a handful or two per day. He is me! I sort of constantly nibble on them.
Are your bowel movements unusual?
My bowel movements are perfectly normal as far as I can tell. Though in the past week, they have been smaller in size, which I find concerning. My food intake has not changed. Very strange indeed. I think I shall lube up my instruments and dive right into your fetid asshole.
Be gentle. Always.
Witnessing history of the making. Kinography, if you will. I'm late to my soup making. I was gonna make soup at 8, but I mean, this riveting story. Hee hee, tickle tickle, hee hee. You can grab the Doc, are you sure you're just playing around? Sorry, I do this thing so often. Don't get it twisted. He starts coming.
Bow down before the one you serve. You're going to get what you deserve. You are not immune to propaganda. You will remember the song from the shitty Jason Statham trailer. And it will command a respect in you, henceforth irrevocable. That is a peanut.
Fantasy Versus. You know what I like about Grand Blue Fantasy Versus is that, because it's, like, spawned from a beloved gacha series that mentally ill people play, there's a lot of fucking idiots playing it. I mean, that's said for most fighting games, but I feel like especially with, Grand Blue. There's like a very big disparity I've noticed in people who have played over 1,000 matches and have like a green square, and it seems like when you fight them that they've played one match, or possibly zero. I guess I said the same thing about Celestial Strive, you know, some people in Strive and Celestial wake up grab, so, like, constantly. Rank doesn't really mean much, I suppose. I think the important thing is, though, it's a genuinely fun game. It's very simple. It's very easy to get into. Anyone can play it. And it's fun. I won't say it has, like, the highest skill ceiling, but there is a skill ceiling. There is, like, you can definitely tell people who know what they're doing versus people who don't. Especially when it comes to Dashlight 66L. If you 66L in Grand Blue Fantasy Versus Rising, you become instantly better than 80% of the player base. I think I like it. At least I like the neutral more than Strive. Then again, I've never really enjoyed Strive's neutral, I just like Nago. If Nago weren't in Strive, I wouldn't ever play Strive. I think that Nago feels very unique for the game that he's in, and he's literally the only reason I would ever play that game. or else I would have stopped playing it a long time ago.
Yeah, buddy, there's an L button. Is that a fucking door? What's going on? Oh, man. I just watched The Nightmare Before Christmas. You know, they go into the forest, that's all the doors that lead to different holidays. This looks like the door that'll lead you to the bananas in pajamas.
Oh, fucking Christ.
Oh, wait, there's... Yeah, sorry, that's a whoa. You guys failed the prediction. That was an undeniable whoa, sorry. Alright, let's see what the prediction was. See what you guys said. 35% that said I won't woe, 65% said not even scary, but he will woe. Okay. There you go.
Can I have a flashlight or something? I know for a fact these butthole surgeons have flashlights. You can see more of the lighting if you go like this, you can cheat. See what's out there?
You are not immune to propaganda.
Peanut Bros, our response. Peanut Sisters, our response.
Saw that post today of the Chad Wojak crying. Says alt tab, game music still plays. And the guy responds to him and says, ha ha ha, just another PC mutt problem, doesn't happen on my PS5, bro. Someone responds to him and says, nothing happens on your PS5, bro. 50,000 free use.
It's funny, because it's true.
My fucking friend DM'd me, I think it was like yesterday or the night before, and said, I don't even know, he said some shit that I woke up and read it, it looked like some schizo shit. He said, just help the little Filipino boy ask his black boyfriend out to homecoming. By setting up a huge teleprompter with rainbow lights and Spider-Man, aren't you fucking jealous? I was like, what are you saying? Because apparently that's a thing that you do. Shit! Actual ass clown. I just continue doing my civic duty? You fucking crazy? Come here, you bastard. I'm gonna kill you. I don't think clowns are scary. I never have. I always thought that, everyone thinks that clowns have to be scary or, like, delightful, you know? You react one of two ways. I always thought that clowns were really depressing. Same thing with people who work as mascots at Disney. I think it's
different for like college football mascots, because usually that's a college kid that's having the time of their life. Or like basketball mascots that like climb up 100 feet in the air and jump off onto a fucking trampoline or something at halftime. Those are mascots that seem like they're having a good time. It's not very depressing. They probably love their job, but the people who like stand there as Minnie Mouse at at Disney World, that like that, I see that and it makes me really, really sad. Holy fuck, dude. He's snacking. My boy get his minerals. He just snacking out. Hey! Hey, let it go, man. Last day of the week, I'm always a little off.
Blood was just hungry.
We should talk like black people more often. Is he gonna come through the fucking walls or something? The colon clown. Hey yo, blood, leave Jit alone. Get off him. Just doing my duty. Don't fly at me, man. Honk his nose with the grabber? I don't know, man. What? It's like he's actually looking me in the eyes. Oh, this is fucking scary, dude. It doesn't work. Fuck off. Actually shot his eyeball out. Sweet. You a clown, punk. You a punk, clown. Not so bad. Chat, this is what's in your ass? What's going on?
I'm serious. Like, I would usually never say this, but I'm here if you need to talk. This is inhuman. Inhuman excrement? What's going on, little blood? This is what happens to your ass if you have too much homosexual sex. You get the ass clowns. Where am I gonna shoot next? His big ugly nose? Here is done. I'm something of a savior. A colon Christ, if you will. No jump scares, please. No jump scares at the butthole. Okay. Is that the last day? Fingers are cold. A triumphant end to a challenging week. All your patients went on to make a full recovery. Oh. I guess the game forgot that there was a shotgun shell in the one lady's butthole, and I cauterized the firing pin, or the primer, and it exploded. You know those intrusive thoughts moments where you're like, oh, the intrusive... Little Blood's intrusive thoughts want... Alright, we'll stop talking about that. But I had a real moment like that when I was in high school. I was probably like 17, 18. There was a shotgun shell on my counter and my dad was cooking. And I grabbed it and I don't know why, but I took it and I hit the primer on the corner of the countertop. I went... And nothing happened. And my dad was like, what the fuck are you doing? And I was like, oh, I don't know. I just wanted to see what would happen. And I I don't think anything. Like, it's very unlikely something would have happened. But if it did, I could have been severely maimed or dead. I think I told you guys that one, like, probably 5 years ago because it stuck with me. But it feels like one of those moments where my dad, like, saw right through me and was just so utterly disappointed. Because he knew it's something that, like, couldn't be fixed. Like, it wasn't, like, a bad grade on a paper. It was like, oh, my fucking idiot son could have just killed himself. The medical research community was thrilled with all the data and specimens you provided them with. But you felt you had reached your peak as a practitioner and decided to retire. Oh, yeah.